In 1987, Canada and the United States recognized 42 areas of concern surrounding the Great Lakes. These were areas where local environmental degradation posed a threat to the larger Great Lakes system. And Toronto and region is one of these areas of concern. A local Remedial Action Plan team has been tracking environmental conditions to ensure that the waters surrounding Canada's largest urban center are drinkable, swimmable, and fishable. Much progress has been made.
The key partners involved in cleaning up Toronto's waterways include municipalities such as the City of Toronto, Peel and Durham, neighboring municipalities, Remedial Action Plan partners such as the federal and provincial government, and citizens. These include continuous improvements in wastewater treatment, restrictions on discharges to storm sewers, and residents' efforts to manage stormwater and remove phosphates from consumer products such as detergents. As a result, phosphorus concentrations along the Toronto waterfront have significantly declined since the 1970s. During dry weather, phosphorus concentrations frequently meet provincial water quality objectives. However, after heavy rainfall, wastewater, stormwater, and runoff are discharged to our rivers and creeks and into the lake, stimulating plant and algal growth. The good news is that the City of Toronto is well underway on the largest stormwater management project in the city's history. The program consists of several projects to address water quality, including the Donna Center Waterfront Project. With a budget of over $3 billion, these projects will help improve water quality in the Don River by upgrading technology and intercepting combined sewer overflows. These efforts will help address water quality to move Toronto closer to delisting as an area of concern.
The aesthetic condition of Toronto Harbour waters are great, thanks to a multi-year study that found that in 80% of all observations made, water is clear, colorless, and odorless. As a result, the status of aesthetic conditions has recently been redesignated to not impaired. Toronto and Region Remedial Action Plan partners have developed a floatable strategy, which is a collaboration of the University of Toronto Trash Team, Ports Toronto, Toronto and Region Conservation Authority, and several City of Toronto divisions, with support from Swim, Drink, Fish, Harbourfront Centre, and the Waterfront Business Improvement Association. This strategy identifies opportunities for removing floatable debris, ongoing monitoring, and preventing floatables at the source. An example is the trash tagging project, which uses GPS-tagged bottles to find out where garbage travels or collects and identify locations where trash-trapping devices such as sea bins could be installed.
Toronto's beaches are in pretty good shape. We have 8 out of the 10 beaches that are blue flag beaches now, and they meet international standards for water quality and for swimming safety. This is a result of the City of Toronto and Remedial Action Plan partners making substantial efforts to reduce E. coli levels. Some of these efforts include the implementation of Toronto's Beaches Plan and research to apply microbial source tracking to identify the sources of E. coli, as well as more rapid E. coli testing methods. Furthermore, water quality issues continue to be addressed through the City of Toronto's Wet Weather Flow Master Plan. One of the great success stories for Toronto's beaches is Bluffers Park Beach, which used to have some of the poorest water quality in Toronto, but thanks to remediation efforts, now meets the criteria for the Blue Flag program.
We've made significant improvement to fish and wildlife habitat across Toronto waterfront. We've seen huge changes in reproduction, foraging, and shelter habitat for the nearshore fish and wildlife communities. Key to this success has been largely due to the efforts of Aquatic Habitat Toronto, a multi-agency partnership group that helped develop the Toronto Waterfront Aquatic Habitat Restoration Strategy, or TWARS. TWARS has acted as the backbone to help guide over 40 habitat restoration projects, restoring more than 55 hectares of new wetland habitat across the Toronto waterfront. Research and monitoring of these projects by Toronto Region Conservation Authority and the Remedial Action Plan partners has shown that warm water resident fish are attracted to these areas for shelter, feeding, and reproduction, and has resulted in a significant contribution to the nearshore fish community across Toronto. Not far from where I'm standing here at Cell 1, we see more than 7 hectare coastal marsh restoration This, accompanied with cell 2 and Bayman D and all the restored habitats of Tommy Thompson Park, result in more than a 25-hectare contribution to aquatic habitat on the Toronto waterfront. What we've learned here, we've applied to the 1 kilometer Donmouth naturalization project, which will create 14 hectares of new aquatic habitat, as well as 16 hectares of new green space or parked land. This project will help reduce flooding, reduce sedimentation, improve water quality, and contribute significantly to biodiversity of the Toronto waterfront.
There's a wide range of aquatic habitat along the Toronto waterfront, ranging from open and exposed rocky shorelines to protected embayments with lots of vegetation and warm waters. Through more than 30 years of electrofishing surveys and nearly a decade of research by Toronto and Region Conservation Authority and Remedial Action Plan partners, we know that these habitats are home to over 70 fish species. These data are also telling us that we need to continue to restore and improve aquatic habitats to support a diversity of fish species and discourage invasive species like grass cut. Continuing with this monitoring will also help track and measure progress towards recovery of native fish populations. In addition to monitoring, Toronto Region Conservation Authority is leading the development of a prioritization tool to identify sites for restoration that will have the greatest benefit to the local fishery.
Most resident fish are now safer to eat, largely because of improvements in contaminants, specifically PCBs and mercury. Residents and visitors are enjoying both catching and eating fish throughout the Greater Toronto Area. Check out our guide to eating Ontario fish for making informed, safer choices. Remedial Action Plan team is preparing a status report on fish contaminant levels and restrictions on eating fish. Once complete, this report will be made available to public.
Over 30 years has passed since Toronto and Region has been designated an area of concern, and the progress made has been remarkable. This is a testament to the commitment of the partners to help secure a healthy Toronto waterfront.